Here on the PowerPoint team, we're always working hard to deliver new features that help you create more impactful presentations in less time. Today, I want to show you the work we've done to deliver two new amazing capabilities. Designer, which automatically provides layout and design suggestions when you add images to your slides, and Morph, which helps you create fluid, video-like slide transitions. Let's start with Designer. Designer was built to save you time creating presentations. It also allows you to create beautiful-looking slides that would otherwise be out of reach. Let me show you some of the steps a professional designer would take to create an amazing title slide. The first thing I'm going to do is add an image so that we're communicating more visually. I'll pick a photo, and I don't want it to just be floating on top, so I'm actually going to send it to the back. Now the text is on top, but it's hard to read, so I need to add some contrast. So I'm going to insert a shape, and in this case I'll use a parallelogram so that it fits with the angular motif of this theme. I'll resize it, I'll change the colors so that it matches the background, and then I'm going to actually move it backwards so that it's behind the text. And then I just need to resize the text placeholders so that it's on top of the shape. Now I've already clocked in about a dozen clicks, and I knew exactly what I was going for, and I know where all the buttons are, and still this slide needs quite a bit of work. So let me show you the same workflow, but with Designer. I'm going to insert the same photo, and that's when Designer comes in and shows me the design ideas. So over here on the right, all I have to do is click on these, and immediately I get a beautiful looking design that's perfectly put together. Everything's in the right place, and it just looks intentional. Designer gives me that option, along with a number of other variations that I can pick from. I'm going to show you one last example, where I'm going to insert a photo of a chart. Designer is smart enough to know that this is a non-photographic image. So instead of giving me background options, it will move the design elements out of the way and place the chart next to them in a way that looks balanced and intentional. Now let's look at Morph. And this is what Morph looks like. You might think this is an animation sequence, but it's not. These are a series of simple slides with transitions that move between them. And it's really easy to use. Let me show you. So for example, you'll notice that Neptune wasn't part of the animation sequence. If I want to include it, all I have to do is come in here and delete these text objects or move them off to the side, maybe make it a little smaller, pull Neptune in, resize it, and bring in the annotations and resize them as well. And now, if I start from the previous slide, Neptune is now part of the sequence, and Morph automatically stitches it all together for me. Just like other transitions, we can render at 30 to 60 frames per second, or as fast as your GPU is able to handle. Let me show you another example. Here I've got a bike, and what I want to do is separate all the parts to show how it's constructed. So I've used Morph to move each part to a different part of the screen, and it automatically stitches it together. So let's say I want to swap these wheels. All I have to do is move them to the opposite sides of the screen, and Morph automatically stitches everything together for me. You can actually modify points to morph between shape geometries. So here, I'm actually turning a square into a rectangle, parallelogram, or a trapezoid. You can also set transforms to interpolate in three dimensions. Both Morph and Designer represent our continued focus on making PowerPoint the best presentation tool for anyone. Not just designers, and not just power users. To get started with Designer and Morph, and upcoming pre-release capabilities in Office, join the Office Insider program today. Thanks for watching.